hungry.
Oh, come on, I'm getting to your stuff, okay?
Yes, they didn't have a man. I'm moving back to the monastery.
They're leaving us? Oh, no.
I can barely talk about this stuff with you. How am I supposed to get up there and just say all of this in front of them? I mean, what if they judge me?
I think if you can tell the truth, you should. I can't work with you anymore, man.
Oh, Jesus Christ, not this thing again. Why? Why? What have I done? Name me one thing I've done.
You wore a wire.
I wore what?
Barry. Kill her.
Just take her off your face.
I can't.
Why?
Because I super glued my hands to the steering wheel.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, it's a weird one.
I remember before the season started, we had talked about
it'd be nice to just have an episode if we can afford it that's kind of in real time, a hit that goes wrong.
He's dead, right?
In season one, Wade Allen, our stunt coordinator, said, I'm friends with this family and they have this little girl who's really good at stunts and she's good at karate. If you ever need a little girl, let me know. And then when the Ronnie Proxen thing was kind of happening, those two things started to line up together and went, oh, what if that's his daughter?
She was like a feral mongoose.
I mean, it was really fun getting to work with Jesse and Daniel. Jesse plays Lily and Daniel plays Ronnie. Those actors are just phenomenal.
Come on, man, don't be an asshole.
There's a scene where Lily runs away from Fuchs and scrambles up a tree. And what you probably don't know watching it is that that tree is CG. And then what we actually had was this green screen pole with a green screen branch going over to the house.
That was the thing where Aida Rogers, our producer, was like, so we'll find a house with a tree. And we found one, and it was not great. And then we were walking by a house, and Aida went, you want it to be something like this house, but the tree's there, right? I'm like, yeah, I think we need to build a tree. And it was just that awful, like, dead silence.
Well, the people in production have to make a decision at that point, right? Like, is it going to be less work for me to talk this idiot out of this?
Yes.
Or is it going to be less work to just do what this idiot wants?
Yes.
Okay, she's not human.
I also directed this episode, and I was just completely, totally a shell of a human being by the end of it. I was so tired.
Well, you wrote it also. This was like your solo album in the middle of it.
What'd you want me to get?
Needle and thread.
Okay.
For stitches.
I understand.
Because I'm dying.
Yeah.
The toughest thing about this episode, writing-wise, was trying to find, well, what's the emotional thread that's going to get us through? And it was like, well, this should be about Barry and Fuchs. You know, Barry, again, realizing Fuchs has always been the person in his life. He was there when he got back from Afghanistan. I love the way Steven looks in that dream, how he looks all, like, in dark. I mean, he looks like like a demon or something. But Barry, at the end of this episode, kind of realizes, like, oh, I was going into the arms of the devil, you know what I mean? It's just kind of like a different episode. You know, some people might like it, and some people might be like, what the fuck?